whenever you will watch this video. So today it would be the last video for the chapter, which is vocabulary building. So in this video we will discuss the last topic, which is free and bound morphemes. So I hope you are ready with your pen and paper. So without wasting much time, let us start this video. So first, free and bound morphemes. So meaning of morphemes is very much important to understand. So over here I have written the meaning of morpheme. So for that morphemes, you have to remember two things. First thing is what? That morpheme is a word or part of word which has meaning. Morpheme means what? It may be a word or it may be a part of the word which has the meaning. Which type of thing? That we will discuss. Right now, remember this thing. Okay, next is what? For morpheme. Further, morpheme cannot be divided. Whatever word you have taken which has some meaning, that word cannot be divided. If we divide morpheme, then it results into meaningless remainders. Meaningless remainders means what? That also we will discuss. But in short, morpheme means what? Two things. First thing means what? It may be a word or part of the word which has some meaning. That means morpheme has some meaning. Second thing is what? That we cannot divide the morpheme. If you will divide the morpheme, then we will get which thing? Meaningless remainders. Means what? That we will understand with the help of the example. As for example, I have taken one word which is boy. So morpheme is a word, okay, or part of a word which has some meaning. Boy has some meaning. Okay. Now second thing is what? Further, morpheme cannot be divided. That means that boy word you cannot divide further. Why? Because it is a morpheme, it has the meaning. But if you divide morpheme, then it results into meaningless remainders. Means what? Supposing that word, that morpheme, if I will divide, so I will divide B plus OY. So meaning of B is what? Nothing, meaningless. OY is also meaningless. That means B and OY is known as what? Meaningless remainders. So clear about that second point also. That first of all, morpheme is what? It's a word or part of a word. And if we cannot divide it further, if you will divide it, so what's happened? You will get meaningless remainders. Another example I have taken, rat. Rat is a word. It is a morpheme. Why? Because it has some meaning. Further, if you will divide that rat, we cannot divide, but if you will divide that morpheme, then what you will get? R plus AT. So you will get meaningless remainders. At has some meaning, but R doesn't have any meaning, so we can say meaningless remainders we will get. So this is all about the morpheme. I hope picture will be clear to you. You can take the screenshot also, because after onwards we will discuss about free morpheme. Now we'll discuss about free morpheme. So free morpheme means what? That we'll study. So over here again, two things you have to remember for this free morpheme. First is what? That the free morpheme comes alone or which occurs alone. It is a single thing which comes alone or occurs alone. That means what? It does not depend on other word. That means such a word is there, that word is not depending on other word. Means what? That it has its complete meaning. That means they are independent. Simple thing is there. One word is there which has some meaning, but that meaning is not depending on another word. Why? Because free morpheme comes alone, occurs alone. As for example, table. For table, I have written something. Table is a free morpheme. Why? Because table has its complete meaning. It does not require any other word to indicate its meaning. That means with the help of table, you can understand its meaning. That means table does not require any other word to indicate its meaning. So that thing we will discuss when we will start with the bound morpheme. That how another thing is required so that meaning of this word is clear to you. Simply, free morpheme means what? Over here two things, they are independent, they comes alone, it has its own meaning, it don't require another word to indicate its meaning. Like chair, fan, house, shirt, TV, radio, dog, book, pencil, door, window, etc. are the examples of free morpheme. So now you can take the screenshot, because after onwards we'll start with the last, which is bound morpheme. Now we'll discuss about bound morpheme. Now bound morpheme means what? Again two things you have to remember. In the free morpheme, what you have remembered, that it is independent, it comes alone, it has its own meaning, is it does not require any other word to indicate its meaning. So that is opposite of free morpheme. So bound morpheme means what? That it is not independent. That means it requires some word so that its meaning is expressed. That means it depends on free morpheme. That means free morpheme is required, which comes alone, which occurs alone, which has its own meaning, and which does not require any other word to indicate its meaning. And bound morpheme means what? It cannot come alone. It don't have any its own meaning. If you want to find out the meaning of bound morpheme, at that time you require one free morpheme. That means meaning of bound morpheme is depending on free morpheme. How? That we will see. Next is what? Bound morpheme is meaningless until it is attached with the free morpheme. One thing, bound morpheme is meaningless until it will attach with the free morpheme. Ha. So over here I have taken one word, which is your enable. Now enable is a word, it is a morpheme. Which type of morpheme, we don't know. Okay. If you will divide that word, N plus able. Okay. So able means what? Able has its own meaning. Its own meaning, and able doesn't require any other word to indicate its meaning. That is why able is a free morpheme. Okay. Now N, if you will write the word N, N means what? It is a meaningless thing. It is a meaningless thing. And if you want to find out the meaning of N, at that time that N should be attached with the free morpheme, then only you can say enable, and then only we can find out the meaning of enable. That means N is what? It is a bound morpheme. It is a meaningless thing. It requires the another word to indicate its meaning. Another word is free morpheme. Okay. Now next word I have taken, weighted. In this weighted word, if I will divide, weight plus ed. Now again, weight means what? We know its meaning. So that weight means what? It is a free morpheme which has its own meaning, which is independent. But if you will talk about ed, so ed means what? Ed is meaningless. Meaningless means what? Bound morpheme. Why bound morpheme? Because if ed you will attach with the free morpheme, then only you can understand the meaning of ed, weighted, past thing. Okay. So this is about the example of bound morphemes. Now picture may be clear to you. Okay. Now bound morpheme means what? In this case, can I say that is your bound prefix? Prefix means what? The word that you are placing before the root word. That is which word? That is your root word. So en is known as bound prefix. So I have written over here, en is bound prefix. Similarly, ed means what? It is a bound suffix. Suffix means what? The word that you are attaching after the root word. So that is your root word. That means roots are always in 99.99% cases, they are free morphemes. And suffixes are always what? Suffixes and prefixes are always which thing? Always bound morpheme. So ed is what? Suffix. Ed is bound suffix. You can write like that. Okay. Now so some examples are there for bound morpheme and free morpheme, or you can say bound suffix or pre-suffixes. Okay. So bound prefixes are which one? Bound prefixes before the root you are writing, and root means what? Free morpheme. So honest, active, operate, Hindu, this all word has its own meaning. That means this all words are which thing? Free morpheme. Okay. Then this, in, co, anti, this, that, these all words having no meaning, meaningless, and that word depends on free morpheme to indicate its meaning. So these all things are known as bound morpheme. And this bound morpheme means what? This words you are writing before the root or free morpheme, so that they are known as bound prefix. Similarly, bound suffix. Suffix means what? After the root you are writing. Root is what? Gardener, accident, child. These all words having their own meaning, so they are the free morpheme. And last is what? ERTALISH. So these words don't have any meaning, they are meaningless until they are attached with the free morpheme, and they are attached at the last so that they are suffix and they are meaningless so that they are bound morpheme. Similarly, I have taken bound prefixes and suffixes over here. These things are meaningless until they are attached with the free morpheme. These things are meaningless until they are attached with the free morpheme. So these meaningless things are known as bound morphemes. The things that you are attaching before the free morpheme are known as bound prefixes. And the thing that you are attaching after the root or free morpheme, these things are known as bound suffixes. So this is all about the completion of meaning of morpheme, meaning of free and bound morpheme with example. So now I would like to end this video. Once again, we will meet in a new video with a new chapter. So till then, read hard, work hard. Thank you very much.